What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of South Jersey Fishing. Today I'm gonna do an unboxing, but I just got it Dick's. Mostly off for saltwater, but I got some freshwater stuff. So let's get into the unboxing. So first up for the saltwater stuff, got some Berkley Gulp Saltwater Series Jerk Shad and Chartreuse Pepper Neon. Pretty sweet. I'm not going to take the gulps out of the package because I'm not fishing today and I don't want to have my hands all smelly. So that's what these are. Got some more Berkley Gulp Jerk Shad and White Pearl, or Pearl White. Then I got some sand eels in a color called Silver Mud. Pretty nice. Stripers love eels. Got some peeler crabs. Amber Glow, it's called. Pretty nice. Some more Berkley Gulp swimming mullet in pink. And I'll be using these as a trailer for what you're going to be seeing, what else I got. I'll show you guys what I use. More Berkley Gulp swimming mullet and chartreuse. Like I said, these are gonna be for trailers for what's coming up again. Extruded bloodworm in color called Bloody. Pretty nice. Some of the stuff my dad bought, so. I bought these, the jerk shads. Jerk Shad and Pearl White. Berkley Gulp Sandworm and Bloody. Berkley Gulp Swimming Mullet Nuclear Chicken. And that's it for soft plastics for that. For Berkley soft plastics for saltwater. Here I have Jawbone Bucktail 3/4 in a chartreuse color. Got more bucktails and 3/4 bucktail jig in a pink color. Let's see, does it say what color it is? No. I just know it's pink, obviously. Got another same size bucktail pink. The reason I chose these colors is because flounder love the wild colors. Got some 1 ounce bucktail jigs, white. Got a 1 ounce chartreuse with white bucktail. Got a 1 ounce growing bucktail in white. 1 ounce bucktail jig in white again. Half ounce bucktail jig and chartreuse with white. Another 1 ounce bucktail with white. And finally, a 1 ounce bucktail jig and white. So that's basically all that I got for salt water. But now let's go over what I got for freshwater. Oh wait, no, there's one more thing. Also for my spinning reel for saltwater, I picked up some Berkley Trilene Big Game 25 pound mono. I got this for 10 bucks. This is such a steal. Like that much line, what is it? 695 yards, 25 pound Berkley Trilene. That is such a steal at Dick's. So I got that. Now that's it, right? Yeah, that's it for the saltwater stuff. Now, let's get into the freshwater. So, for first up is the Berkley Havoc change-up in pumpkin, or blue pumpkin. Let me take it out for you guys. Yeah. There we go. This will look pretty nice on a back of a jig or just punching. That's what I'm gonna probably use it for. If I'm flipping or punching, I'll probably put it on the back of a jig too. There's that. Next, we have the Berkley Havoc Pit Boss in 4-inch and Green Pumpkin. I've never used this color. I've used Watermelon, but I wanted to try out Green Pumpkin. There we go. Pretty sweet. Next, we got some Berkley Havoc 4-inch Pit Boss, like Chibi Crawl. It's basically a bluegill color one. So, there we go for that. And now, I got these because if I want a smaller presentation when the fish are a little finicky, I bought Berkley Havoc 3-inch in black and blue. It's a Pit Boss Junior. I've actually never thrown one of these. Oh yeah. Look at this, guys. It doesn't pick up how small this is. This is really, really small, which is gonna be really, really nice. This is what you would use for like punching, like the juniors. This is what you're gonna use for punching. But I could probably put this on a 3-aught hook, maybe. Maybe a 2. I don't know. Whatever. Whatever fits. And finally, for the soft plastics, Green Pumpkin 3-inch. Pit Boss Junior. God, these things are so small. There we go. Yeah, the camera really doesn't pick up how small these are, but these things are really small. And that's it for the soft plastics. Now, I bought some hooks. Berkley Fusion 19 4-aught EWGs. I got 6 of them. And the reason I like these hooks is, first off, they're ultra sharp. They have the slick set coating on it. And I tend to use these around cover a lot, and I haven't had one bend out yet. I've not had one bend out yet. So that's pretty nice. And plus, I love this packaging. Like, they're not all around hooked on each other. I guess I'll take one out. There we go. Here's what they look like out of the package. Yeah, they're super sharp and sticky. Go for EWG. I wanted to buy the Superline EWGs, but they didn't have them, sadly. But that's alright. I mean, the flipping hooks will do alright. Or the 4-aughts will do alright. Just the regular EWGs. But next we have the Berkley Fusion flipping hook in a 4-aught size. Get 4 of them. And like I said, the reason I like these, ultra sharp, get through cover really easily, and they don't tear up your bait. Oh my gosh, like the VMC and Trocar flipping hooks, they just tear your bait up. Go through pit bosses and stuff like crazy just because how much they tear up your soft plastics. But here's what they look like. Take one out. I've actually never I've used these before, but I've never had my own. Like, I've used some other people's that have these, like my uncle, he has these. But here's what they look like. See the little creature bait stopper right there? Really sharp hook. And I like the barb on these. I guess I'll rig up a Pit Boss on there. Might as well. Now, the best thing for a 4-aught EWG is the Pit Boss, or the 4-inch pimp boss, 4-aught hook, put it in to the end of that. There we go. Go in like that. Push it up. Okay. It's gonna be a little different because I don't have line tied on. Okay, measure where the hook's gonna be. And there you go. That's what the pit boss is going to look like. It's hard to get a good view on it. There's, you can see the stopper right there. Hook barely through. That's what your pit boss is going to look like on there. Really good quality hook. I love it. So that's going to be it for the unboxing today. Hopefully going to get out one day or probably this weekend and fish some saltwater. Don't know about freshwater because my uncle hasn't got a trolling motor yet for his new boat that you guys have not seen yet. It's a saltwater. It's a saltwater boat, basically, and it's really, 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 really nice. I love that boat, especially because you can go in lakes with that thing too. But I think he's gonna buy John boat too. But yeah, that's it for the unboxing. If you guys enjoyed, be sure to hit the like button, and I'll continue doing unboxings. And soon I'm probably going to have to do my, tackle overview. Because I'm doing one every month. And look, got more stuff, so. Tackle overview coming soon. And, well, that's it. So, if you guys enjoyed, be sure to hit that like button. Leave a comment. And if you're feeling extra generous today, be sure to hit that subscribe button, the red subscribe button, and turn on post notifications. All right, guys, I'll see you guys next time on South Jersey Fishing. So, guys, getting back into it, got some bucktails, 1 ounce, 3/4, and 1/2 ounce. Put down maybe quarters or 3/8 ounce. That's it for this box. Next, I'm going to sort this. This is like worm kind of stuff. Here's where it's all the juicy stuff. Berkley gulp and stuff like this, shad baits. These are basically trailers and jerk baits. Now, what else I got at Walmart? Some Power Pro 50-pound 150 yards of braid line. I want to get Berkley trolling braided line, but they didn't have it. And finally, for the reel, I got an Abu Garcia Black Max.